Hello everyone, my name's Heather Butler and I run a ministry called Hidden Treasures Ministries International. And I'm really pleased to be able to bring a word to you this evening called the Transformers. We're going to be looking at Romans chapter 12, verses 1 and 2. And this evening I'm going to be looking at the New Living Translation of this scripture, which I thought was really wonderful. Don't copy the behaviour and customs of this world, but let God transform you into a new person by changing the way that you think. Then you will learn to know God's will for you, which is good and pleasing and perfect. Isn't that wonderful? It's plain, isn't it? Plain enough to understand. So let's just bring the coffee break number 8 before the Lord as we pray. Lord Jesus, I thank you for the opportunity of being able to pray for those that are going to watch the coffee break program. We thank you for the releasing of this word of the Transformers. I pray it will really touch our hearts, Lord, that we would hear something new, that it would ignite within us a passion to continue in our faith. And for those looking in who don't yet know Jesus, we pray, Lord, that they would grasp what it is that's going on here, that it will ignite within them a passion to find out for themselves who this Jesus really is. So Lord, we offer coffee break to you. We offer it Richard to you, the cameraman, and we praise you and thank you for him and pray that you'll bless everything that's said and done this evening. In the name of Jesus, amen. Have you ever watched the Transformers, the movie? Oh my word, it has you on the edge of your seat from beginning to end. What amazes me is that in our world, they were all vehicles. Optimus Prime was a large American truck. Others were sports cars, etc. Amazing, but they looked so ordinary. But the moment there was trouble, they were able to transform into who they truly were, which was mighty warriors ready to defend mankind. There was the power to confront the Decepticons, the dark evil forces whose agenda was to take over the earth and destroy the human race. They wanted to rob, cheat and steal our inheritance from us. Even though the Decepticons were fearsome, they were no real match for the Transformers' might as they protected the vulnerable people of the earth from the onslaught of a ruthless enemy. The battle scenes were astonishing. Suddenly, mankind is not alone as these amazing men from space conquer the enemy on every level to bring order, to bring freedom, and to bring safety once again. The battle for your mind is very real and a battle to be fought most days. Scripture says, be ye transformed by the renewal of your mind. It makes it very clear that to get on with our lives, it's important to change the way that we think. We are the vehicles of the anointing that the Lord has placed in the midst of mankind, full of the awesome power of the Holy Spirit, ready to defend the people of the earth from the onslaught of a very real enemy who wants to keep us out of heaven. And of course, we know him as the devil. We are the modern day Transformers, filled with the depths of the Holy Spirit of God to bring back a people who have gone astray, who are weak and sick, who have wandered away from God and who do not know about the saving power of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. We have to begin to take charge of every situation that confronts us daily, not allowing the enemy a foothold as we move into the fullness of the authority of Christ invested within us to transform the situations that try to take over our minds every single day. There is no name like the name of Jesus. There is no name that is greater. So when he speaks, even the mountains tremble and shake. as he transforms us by the mighty power of the Holy Spirit and enables us to become the vehicles of the anointing that we truly are. But just as the Decepticons in the movie came to destroy, so the enemy comes to destroy us. He will stop at nothing to attack you at every opportunity he gets. He will find your weakest link and attack you in that area, which is very often in the mind. The way you handle these times will pave the way for your future, not looking at the crisis or the problem with your own eyes, but seeing the outcome of it through Jesus. Not listening to the eyes of the enemy, but taking time to pray, to hear what the Lord is saying as you seek his direction. Sheila Booth plays the character of a young man who the Transformers befriend. Because of the strength of the Transformers, he is able to step out and do the most incredible things because he's no longer alone. He's able to fight back. He's able to transform fear into courage, insecurity into feeling secure in who he was, and the surety that he was not alone, that he was in unity with the Transformers. And when he was, anything was possible for him. This young man was transformed by the power. And so can you be if you will enable the Lord to speak to you through this word today. So what changes do you have to make today to seek the Lord about? What weaknesses within you or your family or the place where you live do you have to transform your mind for to deal with it? The enemy has many names, and each one of them is a deceiver. Discouragement. He says, you will never be able to do that. You are a failure. But the Lord will encourage you as you read his word and tell you that he sent his only begotten son for you, John 3:16, and so many more truths for you to build your life upon. Fear. You can't go and minister in that country. You're afraid of flying. Fear not, says the word of God, for I am with you, my rod and my staff, to comfort you. The enemy will come with doubt. Are you sure you can do this? Did God really tell you to do that? You're not qualified. You are not ready. Or we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. This is scriptural. This is what the word says. The word says, go ye into all the world. Do you know it's a finger pointing statement? It's aimed right at you. You go. Insecurity. You're alone. Nobody likes you anyway. But the word says, never will I leave or forsake you. Intimidation. If you go and do that for Jesus, I will make your life hell. But Jesus' word to you today is, and so I tell you not to worry, to be anxious for nothing. And when we come into the place of the word of God, nothing carries more authority than that. Isn't that wonderful to know? That we don't have to fear, we don't have to be afraid. So come on, change your perspective, change your stance. When you're in the valley, everything can feel as if you're closed in. You can't see the light. It's as if a cloud has descended upon you and you just can't see or find your way out of that situation. You know, I've learned through prayer to come up higher. Prayer will give us a vantage point. That's what prayer does. It hands our problems over to Jesus, releasing them to him to deal with, because we're just not able to fix what's wrong ourselves. It's not just asking the Lord to do it, but it's seeking him, asking the Lord if there's anything we could have done differently, asking him to see the situation through his eyes, enabling us to deal with each situation in a godly way. The moment we do this, our perspective changes as we begin to feel that we are not alone, that help is on the way, and suddenly we see things more clearly. We are more focused as we stand on the peak of the Word of God and look down at that problem, and suddenly it's no longer all-consuming. It no longer looms over us. That problem just doesn't look as big as it did. And suddenly, now it's where it should be, under our feet. Amen. Geographically, we're stood in the same place, but now we are standing tall on the promises and the truths of God who will rescue us. No matter who you are, the truth is that God answers prayer. It's not just a luxury for Christians. The Father loves the creation of his hands and longs for you to call on his name, and he does respond. How can I be so sure? What makes me certain that he is a real God who is interested in us? I know that there are some who are watching today who have wandered astray, who need to come back to the fold. I also know that there are some who are not Christians yet. You are searching for the reality of a very real God. So I'm going to give you a testimony to a very real God who saved my husband's life as he struggled with the questions like, is God real? One day, Bob and I were discussing God. And Bob said to me, if your God is real, he'll take those pictures on the wall and turn them upside down in front of my eyes. That was the challenge, and my response was this: well, Bob, he won't do that for you today, but at a time that will mean the most for you. And on that day, you will give your life to Jesus. 7 years had passed and Bob was very ill. He had terrible pain in the kidneys. All the x-rays showed kidney stones, but what was more worrying was a solid mass that they had found in the groin that was large and didn't look good for him at all. A more in-depth CAT scan was ordered by the doctor, who said that a team of doctors were coming up in a week's time and he wanted them to view the x-rays and the CAT scans with him to find the best course of treatment for my Bob. We were concerned, of course we were, but I felt a peace and a calm about the situation and prayed with others for Bob. The day of the CAT scan came. The doctor came out to Bob after viewing them and he looked really perturbed, as if he didn't know what to say. He said that Bob had kidney stones and that, yes, they could have disappeared, they could have dissolved. He could have passed them without knowing. He said, but the solid mass that's in the groin, it's just not there. And he couldn't explain why. He'd had 8 x-rays of Bob's kidneys and groin. He'd had the more in-depth CAT scans. And there was the evidence in front of him, but he didn't know what to say. We were both elated. And then the Lord spoke to me and said, Heather, remind Bob of his challenge to you all those years ago. And I said, you see, Bob, God really did take those pictures and turn them upside down in front of your eyes. Bob said that the hairs on the back of his neck stood on end, and he knew that the Lord had healed him at a time that it meant most to him. That day, Bob gave his life to Jesus. Hallelujah. That word had become a prophetic word for him, and I believed it was a word that saved his life. So if you are challenged by this word today and want to know more or have a comment, please get in touch with me. I'd love to hear from you. Just mention that you watch Coffee Break so that I know it's to do with the program, and I'd be interested to hear what you have to say. So I hope that you've enjoyed this coffee break. And now I'm going to enjoy mine. God bless your week. Amen.